Hello, I'm Graham Steele, CEO and founder of Cryptosense, and today I'm going to talk to you about software keystores, and in particular, the PKCS12 keystore. So if you've been following our series, you'll know that a software keystore is just a file or a format for a file that I can write to storage, to my disk, that's going to contain cryptographic keys. In particular, it's likely to contain public key certificates, so public keys attached to something that tells us who that public key belongs to, and private keys, which are the other half of public keys that I can use, for example, for signing things. So these key stores are supposed to protect the private keys in particular by encrypting them, and also the public keys. The public key certificates should be protected by some kind of integrity check, so I can be sure that nobody has fiddled with them or changed them around in a way that might confuse my application and make it connect to an untrustworthy source and maybe send some sensitive information. So the PKCS number 12 key store is not just a key store for Java like the other ones we've talked to about in our series up until now. It's a interoperable format. So like all of the PKCS series, it was originally defined by the RSA company, so the company that was created to commercialize the RSA encryption algorithms. And this company produced a whole series of standards sequentially. So the standard number one, PKCS1, is a standard that describes how RSA encryption and signature should work. And then they defined a whole bunch of things with a whole bunch of other players in the industry to help get encryption working in a kind of interoperable way. And number 12 defines a format for these software key stores. So like other software key stores, the keys that we use to encrypt the keys, so to protect the private keys that are in there, are derived from a password. So that password is a kind of credential that we can store somewhere secure and then just bring into our application when we need it so it can decrypt those keys. So PKCS12, the first version of it, version 1.0, dates from 1999. So already that's after the design of the JKS and JCEKS key stores inside Java. So it has slightly more modern cryptography in it. But it's also been revised since then, so we're on version 3 now, and it contains support for a whole bunch of much more modern cryptography than those old legacy Java key stores. And indeed, now Oracle recommend that in Java you use PKCS12 as your default key store, you don't use those old Java-specific ones anymore. So what's the cryptography that's in there? Well, in fact, there's two things you have to be very careful of with PKCS12. So one is that even though it does contain support for good, strong cryptography, so for example, for the AES block cipher for encrypting those private keys, and for PBKDF2, so that's a password-based key derivation function, that's the one that's currently approved by NIST. It contains support for those, but you won't necessarily get those by default. So you have to be very careful about the way that your application creates its PKCS12 key store. To make sure that it makes one that uses the most modern cryptography. So you need to look at the parameters that actually set those algorithms up and make sure you're using the more secure ones. And then the next caveat is that even though it's an interoperable format, it's quite an open format, and not every piece of software that says it supports PKCS12 will support all of those different ciphers and all those different modes for calculating the key and calculating the integrity HMAC. So you need to be very careful that if you're creating the key store somewhere to be used by something else, that you're using the strongest possible cipher that's available on both platforms to make sure that will actually work. But PKCS12 is definitely a better alternative compared to those old legacy formats. So if you want to find out more about it, there's going to be some links for a deep dive in the comments. Otherwise, we're going to survey some other ways to store keys and key stores in the rest of this series. So don't forget to subscribe to the channel. That way you'll find out about those too. And until then, I look forward to seeing you again soon here on the Cryptosense channel.